following program is dedicated to the memory of the great Latin dance legend, Millie Dene, and her family in Jackson, New Jersey.
This program is co-sponsored with the New Jersey State Council on the Arts, Department of State, and made possible in part by the National Endowment for the Arts.
For over a century, Latin dances have captivated audiences around the world. In the early 1900s, it was Rudolph Valentino's sensual Argentine tango that took center stage in silent films. By the 1930s and 40s, the conga and the Cuban rumba had planted their dance seeds in America, while Hollywood stars like George Raft, Cesar Romero, Ricardo Montalban, and the samba queen Carmen Miranda showcased the new wave of Latin dances on the silver screen. By the 1950s, a Latin music legend, Pupi Campos, was teaching television audience members how to dance. But nowhere in the world was the golden age of dance more evident than in New York's famous Palladium Ballroom. Here's Ballet Hispanico's tribute to a wonderful era of Latin dance.
In the 1950s, the Palladium Ballroom became world-renowned as the center of popular Latin music and dance. But it didn't start that way. When the Palladium first opened in 1947, it was for whites only. However, because business was poor, a music promoter named Federico Pagani was able to persuade the owner, Max Hyman, to book Latin music. He agreed, but for Sunday matinees only. And so the Palladium became the first downtown dance hall to start a Latin matinee. The music was so successful, though, that it was rapidly booked through the entire schedule. To attract even more customers, the Palladium opened its doors to African Americans, Puerto Ricans, Cubans. And soon, the patrons were a happy melange that also included Upper East Side WASPs and Jews and Italians from Brooklyn. Class and color melted away in the incandescent rhythm of the music. Situated on the second floor of a building on 53rd Street and Broadway, the Palladium quickly became a magnet for great Latin bands and orchestras like Miguelito Valdez, Benny Moray, Cortijo, Charlie Palmieri, Ismael Rivera, Cesar Concepcion, and Mario Bausa, who featured his sister-in-law Graciela, the very famous Cuban singer. But the undisputed masters of music, the big three, Tito Rodriguez, Tito Puente, Machito, whose real name was Francisco Grillo. There was a fierce rivalry among these bands, composed of excellent musicians and led by three musical dynamos. The big three played to sold-out crowds every Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. On these nights, the lines of patrons waiting to get in would stretch for blocks. On some evenings, if you could get to the club before 6 p.m., you paid 50 cents for your admission. Otherwise, you had to hand over the grand sum of $2. And what nights those were. They began at 8 o'clock. Killer Joe Pirro would give mambo and cha-cha lessons to the uninitiated, teaching them to dance on two. The night was filled with the sounds of the big three trying to outdo one another, often playing orchestrations and arrangements by Chico O'Farrell and Ray Santos. The music was relentless. Machito would play one set, then not missing a beat, Puente would step in, followed by Rodriguez, who would blend right in. So it was impossible to tell when one band dropped out and the other began. Nearby on 52nd Street were the jazz clubs, Birdland, The Onyx, Kubop City, and jazz musicians like Dizzy Gillespie, George Shearing, and Cal Jader would stop by and sit in at the Palladium. The Palladium Ballroom attracted the not-so-famous and the famous alike. On any given night, you might rub shoulders with Marlon Brando, Bob Hope, Sammy Davis Jr., Lena Horne, Henry Fonda, Duke Ellington, and others. But it wasn't just the music. It was also the dance and the dancers. The mambo craze that first swept America and then Europe in the 1950s began at the Palladium. Everyone was doing the mambo. The airwaves were filled with mambo hits. Puente with Picadillo, Rodriguez with Mambo Mona, and Machito with Asia Minor. And even jazz greats like Errol Garner, Charlie Parker, and Sonny Rollins fell under mambo's spell, as can be heard on their many Latin recordings from the 1950s. The Palladium proclaimed itself the Temple of Mambo, and the style danced there was particularly elegant, smooth, fluid. But if you went to this ballroom to dance, you had better be good, because you would be among the very best dancers in the world. On Wednesday nights, the popular floor shows featured the professionals like the Mambo Aces and the Cha-Cha Aces. Cuban Pete partnered with Millie Dene. Augie and Margot blended an almost ballet-like style with their dance and added acrobatic lifts and spins. For their performances, they were paid $15 a week. And yes, they were taxed. The irresistible rhythms of the great bands kept the dance floor filled until the ballroom closed at 4 a.m. Ballet Hispanico is pleased to present a tribute to that exciting and golden time when mambo and Latin rhythms ruled the dance floor. And for a while this evening, the Palladium lives on, brighter and more vivid in our memories, with each character larger than life, each more memorable than the next.
Well, we could not recreate the exact period because that would be impossible. So what we took is the ideas of the people that went there and we put them all in one night. We took the socialite, the young girl who's underage who comes in. We took the Casanova. We took the school mart, who's very shy. We took a young boy coming in, a hyper, and the people from the neighborhood that would go to the nightclub, and also the people that went every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And we put them all together on this one night. And what we try to do is look backwards in a loving way to all of the people who inhabit the Palladium.
Angelica Burgos, and I play the character of Mira. And she's the first one to come in into the Palladium nightclub, and I'm everyone's friend. I know the entire orchestra. I know every guest that comes in into the club, and she's just like this busybody. She knows everybody, what's going on, what's going to happen, who should be with who, what needs to happen, and I'm sort of a little bit like in charge of what's happening at the Palladium night.
My name is Rodney Hamilton, and I play the role of Antonio. My wife is Veronica. We are kind of like the owners of the club. We teach the dance lessons. We're the best dancers in the Palladium. You know, we have a big nightclub act, and it's kind of based off of Augie and Margot.
Augie and Margot were Palladium superstars who became internationally famous and were often featured on the hit television program The Ed Sullivan Show.
Our characters are very, very proud to be dancers. Very proud to see that the band is looking nice, that the tables are looking nice, that our clientele is having a good time, and everybody is having a really great time. But at the same time, we have our own conflicts. Being a married couple, you know, being married is not easy. So you know, throughout the night, we have an argument about something that takes us to somewhere else. But by the end of the night, we make up and we get back together, and you know, so it's this love story that goes on with me and my wife there.
It is important to remember that it was Israel Cachao Lopez and his brother Orestes who coined the word mambo in a Cuban dance song recorded in 1938. Also, mambo is an African word meaning conversation with the gods. That is why mambo dancing is a form of communication based on the African traditions of call and response.
Thank you.
amazing because, you know, we are doing ballet steps and then 2 seconds later we're dancing on the two. We're doing a mambo, we're doing the salsa, the cha-cha, and we're just putting everything together. And as a dancer is really wonderful because you're just using every aspect that you've learned throughout your entire career, and all of a sudden it's just in one piece. So it's great.
At the Palladium, Latin bands often challenged dancers to excel beyond their own expectations. They played pulsating rhythms that created a sense of euphoria and tested the dancers' ability to improvise on a variety of accented beats. These jam sessions became legendary moments of an instant creativity at the Palladium.
The dancers have to keep alive, waiting to hear what's happening, and the musician is seeing the dancer, and whatever the dancer does, they respond. So that's why it's so magical. There's dancing with live music, there's nothing like it.
Ballet Hispanico's Palladium Nights features the big band sound of Arturo O'Farrell, son of the great band leader and Palladium legend, Chico O'Farrell. Arturo stays true to the tradition of challenging the dancers to be creative.
It keeps it alive for us because, you know, you find a lot of different things. Every night the show is very different. You know, sometimes they play slower, sometimes they play faster, sometimes the note's higher here or a little bit longer there. So, you know, it really keeps us on our toes, and they're really wonderful with watching us and, you know, catching little things here and there with the cymbals and things like that. So it's really, really interesting to do it because, you know, in the dance world we don't normally improvise on stage, and we're not really improvising, but we're having to recreate a new ballet every night, which is really, really exciting for us.
It's this energy that starts off like a volcano that we just feed off each other. It's amazing playing with them. They're the best.
In addition to the best music and dancers, the Palladium also required that men and women dress to impress. Elegance and style gave the dance movements a sense of class. Meanwhile, outside the Palladium, social issues were still a great concern.
Socially, remember that the United States was segregated at that time, 1947, right after the war. But there was one place where it was not segregated, and that was the Palladium. And in fact, you know, when we were researching the Palladium, we found out the police department had taken a lot of photographs of the people waiting to get into the Palladium. Everybody dressed, and you dressed specially to go downtown because it was not your neighborhood.
Of course, you have to come with your Sunday best, your Saturday best, your Thursday best, whatever day it is, you better be on top of it, or, you know, it's just not going to happen. And that's the thing, you know, we have to really go back into history and think about these things, because for our generation, you know, we could go to the clubs and, you know, wear tennis shoes and jeans and things like that sometimes. But in, you know, the 1950s and 60s, that's not how it happened. You know, everybody had a suit, tie, or, you know, nice shoes, nice dress socks, hair combed, you know, no hats, no glasses. So it's very different, very, very different atmosphere to be aware of that, a lovely atmosphere as well.
Even the bands, special guests, and professional entertainers had to dress to draw attention, respect, and admiration.
In that period, we were very careful how we dress and what we wanted to project, not only on stage, but off stage, because there wasn't as much work as there is now. So you made sure that you looked the part, and that if they were going to choose someone, it would be you. Everybody in my school, at least that goes to my school, while they're in the school, they're properly dressed and groomed.
The art of professionalism is also being taught at the Starlight Studio in Nutley, where young dancers learn from the past.
In the 1950s, it was pretty different than how we do it, but it looked like fun.
Like in the 1950s, I saw it was more freestyle, and like almost all of the steps were different. Still, like today in modern day, it doesn't look like cha-cha. It looks like a completely different dance. Yeah.
The cha-cha-cha was a dance step and rhythmic pattern that was originally a part of the mambo. When it branched off, it became one of the most popular and innovative dances at the Palladium.
Oh my God. We think they were pretty amazing, weren't they?
Oh my gosh, and it was a lot more fast-paced. Yeah. I noticed that.
I know some people from the Palladium area, they come here to dance because once a month we're running a salsa night. We call it Noche Caliente. The new dancers who come, they're the same way, enjoy watching them dance. They try to copy what they do.
What I try to teach is the good feeling that they're supposed to have inside and put the feeling from their body into the dance floor.
Similar to the Palladium era, men and women of different nationalities often paired off as dance partners.
Just having fun, going out and dancing. You know? That's what it's all about.
Viva Palladium!
A lot of people are not aware that in the 50s, in the Palladium, they was already doing certain dances that they think is from this era. But actually, in the 50s, they was already doing it. Like the break dancing, the pop locking, the voguing, the electric boogaloo, like we call it, but they call it pop locking today. So these are the moves that were the foundation at the beginning, which evolve into other forms of dance.
But it was the mambo that became the favorite dance at the Palladium, and among the great dancers was the sensational Millie Danae. She became an international star and was the lead solo dancer for Damaso Perez Prado, the king of the mambo. In 1943, he created and introduced the first mambo dance steps at the Tropicana Club in Cuba.
I'm Addie Diaz, and I am a New York mambo dancer. I had the opportunity to be a cast member and a choreographer of the off-Broadway musical Latin Madness. And I had the privilege to portray Millie Danae, who is a mambo legend, a Palladium dancer, a pioneer for female Latin dancers.
It was at the Palladium that the young Italian Millie Danae teamed up with a Puerto Rican dance legend, Pedro Aguilar. Nicknamed Cuban Pete by Desi Arnaz and crowned by Life magazine as the greatest mambo dancer ever.
So we just have to do a tribute to those dancers that made the Palladium the mecca of mambo dancing.
A message to Millie Danae's family. I'm so grateful for the opportunity. She was a wonderful woman. I know you guys already know that, but to me, she meant a lot, and she's a big influence in my life, in my career.
If you're going to get into this business and you love dancing, what you have to do is really concentrate on watching many people dance and watching their personalities while they're dancing. And then you have to practice and develop your own style. You must bring in your own soul to whatever you do, and you'll make it from there.
This is the same message Cuban Pete is teaching dance students from around the world. Dance en clave and dance with your heart and soul. In honor of Cuban Pete and Millie Danae, we decided to recreate the Palladium days at Crystal's nightclub in Lyndhurst, New Jersey.
My name is Solange Rodriguez. I am the winner of the Jennifer Lopez Dance Contest. I'm here with 102.5 FM, celebrating the Palladium. I am playing the character of Marilyn Winters, and she is...
Diana Osorio, playing the role of Millie Donet. It's truly an honor to play Millie Donet. She brought so much class and elegance to the dance floor. And being able to be a part of paying tribute to those who started salsa and showed us our style is truly an honor. And here's my partner, Cuban Pete.
Hola, mi nombre es Josué Torres, and I play Cuban Pete, one of the legends from the Palladium, and one of the great dancers who initiated a lot of the moves and style that we do today.
Hi, my name is Anna Garcia, and I played one of the dancers that went to the Palladium, and the best dancers went to the Palladium.
And I'm Elio Arce. And you're gonna see the moves, and I hope you like mine.
Hello, my name is Juan Antonio Calderon, and I'll be playing Killer Joe Piro. He was known for teaching all the Hollywood stars all the moves. He was also the MC, and he threw the dances. Killer Joe is known for his head bopping, so when you see me do this on the video, it's one of his moves. They used to call him the Rooster because of the bopping of his head and the way his hair moved when he did it. I'm honored to play it. You're also gonna see my dance company, Culture Explosion, doing a Rueda de Casino.
Now stand up and move your chairs. Get ready to move because we're gonna dance
Palladium style.
Playing the role of the big band of the Palladium is Ray Rodriguez and Orquesta Swing Sabroso. From 1957 to 1960, Millie Donet paired with Marilyn Winters to form the first and best two women side-by-side Latin dance team. Millie Donet who created the famous female body roll.
Baila,
To the people in the Palladium, thank you very much.
What makes the Palladium Days important is that it opened Latin music to a whole new genre of ethnic groups.
Pete, if you're watching, thank you for all that you've done for this music.
Above all, we must thank Henry Medina Archives for the wonderful footage seen on this show, and the producers of Mambo Madness for capturing the Palladium era on film. And always remember that Palladium dancing was about class, creativity, and romance. Relive it again with someone you love, and dance with your heart and soul. Hasta pronto, amigos.
Es fuego que quema y se mete en mis venas.